Hi, I'm Chris Rowe, and welcome to Understanding and Using Elk Bugles and Bugle Tubes. If you're like me, and thousands of other elk hunters out there, at some point in your preparations for elk season each fall, your attention ends up turning to elk calls, and especially these, bugles and bugle tubes. Whether it be to simply practice up a little bit and brush up on the ones that you already have, or maybe it's to check out a new bugle or bugle tube in hopes that it might be a little easier to use, or maybe give you a different sound than the one that you currently have. But with so many different types of bugles and bugle tubes on the market these days, it can be a bit confusing, if not downright overwhelming, trying to figure out how to use some of the bugles and get the best sound out of them, which ones are the easiest to use, which ones give you the most flexibility, how the different bugles and tubes are going to sound in comparison to one another, or the one that you currently have, or just plain which one you should buy if you happen to be in the market for one. Over the next few videos, we're going to go a long way into helping you figure all that out. Now, before we begin, let me be clear that this series is not a sales pitch for any particular company per se. Neither this nor the companion series, Understanding and Using Cow Elk Calls, is sanctioned by or endorsed by any company in particular, and is not meant to bash any company or their products. Rather, these videos are intended to show you how to use the different types of bugles and bugle tubes, help you understand the mechanics of and the realities around the different types of bugles and tubes, and help you make a more educated purchase when you're shopping for a bugle, and then get the most out of the one or ones that you do purchase. With that said, there are a number of manufacturers of elk bugles and tubes out there, with each having different styles, designs, and materials that they use for their calls, and the associated marketing that goes along with them. Because of the different designs and materials, some bugles and tubes do sound better than others, both between manufacturers and even within a particular manufacturer's line. In this series, we're going to go over a few of the different types of bugles and bugle tubes that are available on the market today from several different manufacturers and help you understand how to use them and what their strengths and limitations are, or what their advantages and disadvantages are from my perspective, based on their design and the materials that they're made out of. Again, the goal is to give you the information that you need in order to decide which call is right for you and help you get the best sound and use out of the one that you might already own. As we go through the videos, we'll go from the most basic and easiest bugles to use to those that I consider to be the most versatile, but that might take a little bit more practice to master. And we'll break them down into what I consider the different classes of bugles and tubes that are available. Now, there is no way to cover all the bugles that are out there on the market, but I'll go over the different classes of calls within the four companies that are probably the most popular, or at least that you're likely to see on TV, or hear folks talk about at your local sporting goods shop, or in online chat forums. Those being Primos Hunting Calls, Bugling Bull Game Calls, Hunter Specialties or Carlton Calls, and more recently, Mossback Game Calls. As far as the different classes of calls that we're going to be talking about, we're going to cover manual calls, those that require you to blow through them but manipulate the sound by hand, external reed style calls, and mouth diaphragm calls. As far as the different tubes, whether you call them bugle tubes or grunt tubes, doesn't matter, we're going to cover the compact bugle tubes, the collapsible bugle tubes, the full-size tubes without any sort of resonating chamber on them. We're going to talk about the full-size tubes that do have a resonating chamber on them. And then we're going to wrap it up by talking about the wiffle ball bat style, or just the plastic bat style tubes.